Hi.
Hark!
Confederate General Presbyterian Deacon and horrifying neckbeard host organism Stonewall Jackson believed that one of his arms was longer than the other, and so he was constantly holding it up above his head to improve circulation. But Stonewall, if you're having problems with asymmetrical arms now, just you wait, buddy. Because after his victory at the Battle of Chancellorsville, Stonewall and his troops were on their way back to camp after reconnaissance at night, and another Confederate regiment found them and thought they were the enemy. And Stonewall said, "Don't shoot, we're your friends." But the other regiment commander was like, "No, it's a Yankee trick, open fire." And Stonewall was shot 3 times, twice in his left arm and once in his right hand. He was taken to the doctor and his left arm was amputated. Now the Confederacy had such a case of hero worship with Stonewall that his chaplain did not want for a single body part of the good general to go without its due respect. And so he only thought it right to give Stonewall Jackson's left arm a proper Christian burial at Elwood Manor in Stafford County, Virginia. And so the arm, not the rest of Stonewall, just the arm, was laid to rest under this gravestone, which literally reads, "Arm of Stonewall Jackson, May 3rd, 1863. And Stonewall wasn't even dead yet. He's one of the only people in history who could legitimately visit his own gravesite post-burial. It wasn't until 7 days later that Stonewall himself succumbed to pneumonia and was buried in a separate grave in Lexington, Virginia. They didn't even bury him next to his arm. We're hearing a lot of debate nowadays about the right to bear arms. But that army chaplain didn't want that left arm left behind. He wanted to do the right thing and bear that left arm right to the burial site. But wait, did he bury the arm in an army uniform, or was the arm bare? Because we talk about the right to bear arms, but army pallbearers bearing that bare arm to be buried isn't quite what we're talking about. Stonewall Jackson could have had many nicknames, such as Hypochondriac Jackson, Sleepyhead Jackson, Bad Horseman Jackson, Slaveholding Dingus Who Thinks African People Are an Ignorant Race Because They're Not Christian Like He Is Jackson. But no, he was nicknamed Stonewall because he was known for his stalwart tenacity in battle. He always held his ground, much like a stone wall would. You would never want to get into a battle with Stonewall, because before his little accident, he was a very formidable military commander. I mean, Robert E. Lee even referred to Stonewall as his right arm. And after Stonewall's accident, you still wouldn't want to get into a fight with him because, well, it just wouldn't be a fair fight. You see, Stonewall was disarmed. Stonewall Jackson's arm is an oddly specific topic to vlog about, but that's what I do. This is season 2 of HarkVlogs, where I make a video once every 2 weeks about an oddly specific topic that I think is amazing, that I want more people to know about, to hearken to. I'll put a link to season 1 of HarkVlogs in the video description, and I will see you in 2 weeks for my next oddly specific topic, goats in trees!